Hey guys, how's it going? Blaine here, aka Thrifty Fishing, playing some Balook Spiders again. I'm just gonna queue up, see if we can get a game. Oh, immediately, going up against BGG. I'm gonna throw away only scavenge here. I don't mind having to wait a turn two. We might draw into a two drop anyway, so I think this turn one dropping of the goat rabbit is just one of the best. Hopefully he passes turn one. That way, we won't be too behind if he plays something on turn two. All right, so he passes turn one. If we can get a turn two pass, it's gonna be a good day. We already starting the heel train, boys. Hop on the heel train. Here we go. Oh, that turn two pass though. Getting that one attack in, extending that gap. That's what we're here for. Now I'm gonna go ahead and play this, get that card draw going. Actually, do I want? Is it worth having 5 mana next turn? I say yeah, because then if we draw into something better than this, you know, we can just play it. No way he's passing turn three too. That's like the worst mulligan of all time. If he's got no turn one, turn two, or turn three. But surely that's not the case. Okay, he's dropping the lucrative. Same thing as this. Lucrative's a staple. Great turn three. Grabbing that fallen star. Gotta love that card. Swinging for two. Extending the ever-growing gap between our healths. Getting this draft in. All right, let's see. What are we gonna draft? Absolute fire might be nice come later, just 'cause I mean we can use a turn of 10 mana and do 10 damage. I mean it's right there in the card, you know. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab that for this probably late game play. All right, now the buffs are coming down. Hopefully he's not about to hit this with something dangerous. You know, we're just gonna buff that up. We play in a Weppawall Egg Mother. Keeping that heal train going up to 29 health. Keeping our goat rabbit alive, making him a 3/4 now. It's gonna be good time. Look at this, he's playing Sunflower. Drawn by Toucan, created by me, you know. He's playing my own card against me, boys. That's just not fair. We got this boy coming in attacking. And you know what? We just gonna let him do that. And we're gonna double swing. Now he can block this with that, but we still get the experience. So I'm gonna call that worth it. Even if he blocks my rabbit, he's still fine. Yeah, we good. We keeping the heal train. That puts that in the one health. That's perfect fallen star next turn. I mean that's just money. Now, he is gonna get to kill something with this. Probably this, if I had to guess. So we're gonna buff the goat rabbit just in case. But like I said, I doubt that's gonna work in our favor. So we're gonna fallen star him, kill this, kill that. Yeah, and we'll call that a turn. We'll heal up again with the goat rabbit. We'll be at 28. He's swinging with three, you know, but that'll just drop us to 25. Drop him down to 15, so we're just gonna take it. Oh, we're grabbing this Fallen Star part two. All right, getting it back with our crab here. Healing up twice for six more health. Not six, I'm crazy. That'd be three. We only got two. Healing up for four more health. Oh, he's killing our rabbit, boys. That was scary. Killed in cold blood. What a monster. I'm actually gonna block this. I have a feeling he's attacking with the speed he has. We're just gonna block him. Oh, the sunflower doing work. Trying to decide how I want to eliminate him this turn. So if we come in here like this, that's gonna still be alive. That's unfortunate. If we come in here on this, that's gonna still be alive. It's got ward. That's also unfortunate. I'm almost tempted to just leave them all alive except for this. Go ahead and drop her and then just cataclysm next turn after he plays a bunch of minions. That seems like the best choice to me. I could be crazy. But that's what I'm thinking, because she's probably about to duel something. You know, maybe take one damage. So that's what we're just going to blast this Joker to infinity. And then prep for that cataclysm next turn. Or, I mean, we could just target this, get rid of her ward, and then use that remaining four to kill this. I mean, then we just got, I mean, board advantage, but he could be playing minions right now, so we don't know. We don't know what's going to happen. We're going to go with it. We'll see what happens. Alright, so he's got the speed demon coming down. He did duel with that, so that call was correct. Kill this with the block. That's not so bad. Maybe draft something crazy. I'm gonna take this demon heart. I like having lots of removal. Alright, so we have initiative. I got a feeling this is probably coming onto this to kill it. Unless he's like crazy predictions here. But I have a feeling that's what's going to happen. So what I'm thinking is that we buff this up. It'll become a 4-5. He'll attack into it and die. We'll get to keep our minion. That'll be great. And then we'll also drop this Egg Mother. He might be saving it specifically for getting his passive off, but I don't think that's going to be the case. Did not attack with it, or it would be great out here. Playing his card Frog-a-Lot. Let's see which three he got. He got the Traitorous Knight. Can't see the other two there. I'm not gonna have anything. That'll drop him down to 10. I'm just going to try and kill everything he... Oh, grabbed the wrong card there. Kill everything he's got so I can swing big. Let's see if I can see his... Nah, I can't see what those are, unfortunately. They have a duelist. So, but, oh, I don't know why I even said that. They've all got duelists. They're the Frog-a-Lot. The Frog-a-Lot frogs. They all got duelists. This is quality art, BGG, if you're watching. Quality art, dude. This looks great. These streamers around the table, that's just phenomenal. Also, look at this consistent graveyard. We got two hunters, we got two demons. Oh, there's two speed demons, two lucratives. Alright, we got the Brave Knight coming down with just hella health. No feast, says, over here. Oh, fall of the week doesn't work. Oh, I just got cheated so hard. I'm so sad now. Well, at least he can't block with any of that. So I get to swing for six. And I get to drop this Duelist Destroyer. Actually, I wonder if it still can duel after it loses Duelist. I'm not sure how that interaction takes place. But we're about to find out right now. So it looks like they still get to duel. And I just think that's nonsense. Oh, the angel of salvation coming in, just saving his life, ruining mine, making me sad. So we're just going to Cataclysm this turn. He's got initiative. Go ahead and just kill off everything he plays this turn. See if we can't get back in this. He's taking his time. He's trying to think of the play here. He's about to throw a flipping, Oh, no counterspell. I was worried the counterspell was coming down. Man, he's getting some actual value out of Frogmite. Three cards on an off Cataclysm turn, so now he's got that comeback board next turn. Genius. Now, I'm just going to pass, let him play all of these, and then Cataclysm again next turn, because I think that'll just be hilarious. Alright, look at this. We got the Gentle 1-5 and the Fierce. Now, this is interesting. Those don't have duels. Which is really weird, because that Hecate's is not still in play. So that's interesting. So another Cataclysm went down. Actually, we're gonna. I'm trying to think if I need to play around Counterspell. I'm just gonna assume he doesn't have one. Oh, I should have played him after that, what I was thinking there. Misplay. Misplay alert. I'm going to go check out this Hecate's programming situation, try to figure out why everything has lost Duelist for the rest of the game, because that's certainly not intended. My dude, that makes me sad. What is he gonna discard? He lost his one of his frog knights, the Traitor's. I'm gonna take this counterspell just because that would be fun. So we're gonna start off with a counterspell. Then we got this coming down. The Cuckoo. Actually, we're not going to use that because we're going to swing face for 9. Unless he's got another angel coming down. Alright. Alright, so I'm looking at the ward design competition, trying to figure out what's up with Hecate's Peace Singer here. I made this card, so if it doesn't work, you know, it's all my fault. So now I need to go to the editor. And let's see how this thing works. Alright, it says remove duelist from cards in play. And this change will not persist across zones. So that's weird. We've got him down to 3. This could be it, boys. We're going for the win. Oh, okay. There comes the conceit. Good game, BGG. That was a good one. I'll see you guys again next time. Thanks for tuning in.